sniffing out COVID in kids.
WGN's Zena Bayer has more on a new, easier detection method.
It works like a breathalyzer used to perform field sobriety tests. No nasal swab necessary, just blow out, and this version will look for signs of SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID. The emerging technology may change how kids are screened at school. It's science rooted in another infectious disease. At Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, Chief of Infectious Diseases Dr. Audrey John had already identified specific biomarkers, actual smells in the breath linked to malaria.
There's really two potential places that these smells can come from. They can come from the bug itself, the bacteria, the virus, or the parasite that's causing the infection, or they can come from your body's response. In our malaria work, think that some of the volatiles are actually being made by the parasite and actually making it out of the lungs.
That's not the case in COVID.
When you get infected, then your body's immune response is dramatic, and it changes the metabolism, the kinds of things that your body is making, and then we can see that in your breath.
This is the tool they currently use, a mass spectrometer. But the hope is to refine the technology to the size of a breathalyzer used to detect alcohol in field sobriety tests.
We have the child actually blow into a bag, collect the air onto something that then we can shoot onto the machine. And the machine really just gives us a readout of everything that's present, sort of from A to Z. This is all the stuff that's there.
They collected breath samples from both infected and non-infected children. In kids with COVID, they identified 6 specific elevated biomarkers. Dogs helped sniff them out in the lab.
The dogs had already shown us that they could sniff out the difference between children with and without COVID. They just do it in their noses.
In her study, Dr. John found the 6 biomarkers could predict infection with 91% sensitivity and 75% specificity.
Just using 6 of the things that are different, we get a very high sensitivity. That is, we're really quite easily able to detect the children who are infected. Our specificity is not as great as current tests. So what we see is that some of the kids that we think are positive, a couple of them turn out not to be positive.
PCR tests have more overall accuracy, but ultimately Dr. John hopes to see the technology deployed in schools and at home. No lab needed.
I think there's gonna be a real need for a while to be able to tell when your kid's got a runny nose and cough, is it just like something boring that you don't need to worry about, or is this a reason everybody needs to stay home for a week?
Right now, the researchers are testing the breathalyzer in other respiratory viruses that have emerged this summer, including RSV. They hope to secure more funding to bring their technology to the masses. Back to you.